We have new talk show host Mike Buscetti coming in to
9 o'clock.
Promote his new program.
No wonder you were kind of being dismissive of James Corden.
Sure.
You're not trying to give any late night love to any hosts except for our friend,
yeah,
Mike
Buscetti.
Yeah,
he's got his own talk show.
Now, have you seen the talk show?
I've seen moments of it, yeah.
Okay. Did you watch the Mike-a-log?
I saw some of it, yeah. A lot of laughs? Yes.
Okay, good, good. I was able to watch the entire premiere.
Oh, good.
We got Mike Buscetti coming in just a little bit. He's got a brand new late night.
Well, is it a late night?
He's calling it a late night, but okay. It's streaming. You watch it whenever you want to watch
it.
Yeah. But it's a late night show.
Yeah.
You know, it's low budget on purpose. It's called Bo Shetty's Basement.
Yep.
And
we'll have
good.
To go with that. The Mike-a-log.
The Mike-a-log. He does a segment that I would. Is it technically a Man on the Street segment?
Yeah.
Man on the Street segment. He has a musical guest. He has a co-host. He has an announcer. He does impressions. You'd think they were the real person. It's incredible.
How many have you watched, Travis?
One.
Yeah, I think there's only one available right now.
Can't wait for the rest.
Yeah.
Will you watch them?
I will watch every single one.
You got to subscribe to get
it. Did you enjoy it?
I'm a loyal, whatever Mike is calling his listeners.
Yeah.
I'm one of them.
Okay.
You got to subscribe to TVRemix.com, I think, to get the rest
I'm
of it.
I'm not going
to
do that.
Yeah, I'm not going to go
no?
do that. But
no.
I suggest other
that
people
loyal?
Do.
No, $5 a month.
Oh, you got to pay for it.
Yeah.
Well, Mike, you got to establish, or maybe do a Patreon where like, you do extra stuff. Like, you let them, you know.
Like extra Mike-a-logs?
What do you, I mean, Mike is not.
I'm going to talk to him when he comes in.
Yeah.
Okay. Mike is not doing this himself. He's
I
got
love
people.
It,
all right. You want to get people on board with it.
Originally, this was supposed to be on Amazon, he said.
Ah.
And he even referenced it being on Amazon in the episode, but it's not on
I
Amazon.
Noticed that.
Not on Amazon.
But what happened?
Another network scooped it up.
Yeah, this TV Remix place.
There was a war, and these guys won it.
That's true. That's true. They have the new Late Night Wars book. The guy, Bill Carter, didn't he write Late Night Wars? And the second book? They're great books. The book about Letterman and Leno, and then the book about Leno and Conan. I love those books. He's writing a third book about Buscetti and going to TV Remix or Amazon.
Oh, like it's going to have like a sticker on the front that says like new chapter.
Yeah.
The movie Shetty's about Letterman and Leno was very good.
The HBO one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was based on his book.
Wait, it looked just like them.
I mean, you know, the casting choices were questionable.
A little odd.
Yeah.
Letterman looked like Letterman.
Letterman did look like Letterman.
Leno, Oh, there's Mike, our last comic standing.
Look how terrible Mike's site looks.
Well, why?
What's wrong with this site?
Troy, why are you such a hater?
Why is everything blurry?
You're coming in here in a bad mood. You're sitting here, you're telling me I don't like Les Mis. You're telling Mike Buscetti his website stinks.
You're going to tell me that looks good?
I wasn't going to say anything about it.
But why is everything, like, blurry?
Well,
I mean, because the photos.
It doesn't look good.
They're blown up.
No, it's blurry because it's the background.
No, everything's blurry.
He just checked in. You guys want him in now?
No.
Okay. We'll discuss our weekend first.
We got to discuss our weekend.
All right,
Troy,
we'll circle back to that.
Takes an Aruba vacation. He comes back in a bad mood somehow.
No, I'm in a great mood. I'm just pointing out the obvious.
It's true.
The site's not that great.
I know. Troy's like a real fucking, Troy's like a mini bar in the Dominican Republic.
Yeah. No. Well, we will take a break.
Yes,
we have
we will.
Late night's newest name, Mike Buscetti.
That's which is nice.
Coming in.
Yeah.
I wish he had been at Colin's wedding.
I'm surprised he was. It must have been a miscue.
I'm sure he was busy.
Sure.
I'm sure he's probably filming more episodes, quite frankly. He's a busy guy these days.
Yeah. Hi,
here
Mike.
He comes.
Good to see you, buddy.
He is the newest name in late night. He's got Colbert quivering. He's got the British guy that we were just talking
James
about.
James Corden.
James Corden is shitting himself. Yeah. And Letterman has given up his Netflix show. That's how much of an impact Mike Buscetti is making.
I think one guy's really scared. The guy that plays board games and fakes laughs at people.
Who's that?
The board game player that fake laughs. He's always laughing at nonsense.
Who?
Take a guess, guys. Pay attention.
No, is it Alan? Why are you taking shots at Jimmy Fallon?
He sucks.
Why?
Yeah, why, Mike? God.
Why? Why do you think Jimmy Fallon sucks?
I hate the Tonight Show if that would happen to those. Well,
what happened?
On.
No, go ahead.
No, the thing is, like, there's two Jimmys on late night. One of them's genius and the other fucking plays good board games.
Now, does Jimmy Fallon actually play board games on the Tonight Show?
He used to a lot.
He does, okay.
But you like Kimmel. Yeah,
but why
how original is Parcheesi?
Why, I didn't know he plays Parcheesi.
It's a fun game.
Why do you hate Jimmy Fallon so much?
I'm only breaking balls.
I don't think so. Why do you not like him?
He said he sucks.
Yeah, why do you think he sucks?
I'm just warming up for you guys because I've been sitting out there a while. I'm getting a little fucking...
We apologize for the delay.
A lobster in a fucking pot out there, you guys got.
I mean, but you know what it's like to host a show at this point, Mike.
Yeah, well, you know, we all can have, you know... We got to throw some wood in the fire, fellas. You know what I mean?
We got backed up on Reeds.
We had our last guest. We got delayed in our last segment. We were playing Chutes and Ladders with one of our guests.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Candy. That candy fucking cane game you guys got.
Candy fucking cane.
So at what point did you realize that Jimmy Fallon was not your cup of tea?
I want to talk to you guys about something else. Conspiracy theories.
Okay, sure.
I've been doing a lot of reading, right?
Oh.
Petrified wood, that bullshit wood that you find where the Sequoia Redwoods are, right?
Yeah.
Right. Is that something that's like millions of years old, it's magical? Or is it by some fucking hillbillies who wanted to fuck with us?
I'm not sure where that can... Why would they fuck
Troy,
with us?
You watch Ancient Aliens, right?
Yeah, I love Ancient Aliens.
Is petrified wood magical?
I don't think it is.
That hasn't been covered. Like, Giorgio Tsoukalos ever cover that?
David Childress may have.
Okay.
Petrified wood is like that shit that those saber-toothed tigers ate probably 20,000 years ago.
Mike, I don't know what you mean.
Mike, you're going off the rails.
Petrified wood was is a hoax and saber-toothed tigers ate it?
No, but...
Why would petrified wood not be...
Who would fake that?
Some people wanted to fuck with people. Think about those Egyptian like tablets they wrote. How do you know they're fucking pranking each other?
Mike,
pranking each other? So you think basically that petrified wood is a Jackass episode?
No. Think about the hieroglyphics they have in ancient Egypt, right? How do you know they weren't fucking playing pranks with each other in those days?
Been, but what difference does that make?
Doesn't matter.
No,
still Egyptian. Old.
I mean, it's still hieroglyphic. Whether it's meant in jest or seriousness, it's still impressive that they had a written language, no?
Yeah, well, yeah, I'd rather have non-written ones more impressive than me.
Well, they had that, too. How could you have a...
Yeah, they would draw pictures on cave walls.
Oh, yeah.
If you had a non-written... If you didn't have a non-written language, how would you read?
Well, some Native American people had non-written languages, though, too.
No, of course you have, but you just... said I'd rather have a non-written language. You cannot have a written language without a non-written language because then you couldn't read it. Right?
Well, you got me really confused right now.
Yeah, we don't know what you mean, Mike. We're trying to hang in there.
I'm trying to find out why you don't like Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah, why?
Well, you know what? I don't know how much dues he paid in this.
Well, he was on SNL for a long time, and he was a stand-up.
Yeah, but you know what? Lauren fucking kissed a lot of people's asses on there. There's a lot of people that blow on that fucking show, too.
Who?
Well, who do you not like on
SNL?
Well,
you know, my favorite cast was, besides the originals,
yeah,
Farley, Sandler, Spade, Schneider, all those
guys.
So
you hate Will Ferrell?
No, I don't hate Ferrell.
You don't like Norm?
Norm and Ferrell, cool. I like those
guys. Why do you hate Colin?
I don't hate Quinn. He just got married. Congratulations, Colin.
You don't like Colin, though?
No, I like Colin. I mean, you know, whatever it is.
So wait, you and Colin, whatever it is,
you guys have beef?
Is there beef?
No, he just had a heart attack. I feel sorry for him.
Were you guys competing over whose heart attack was worse?
His might have been a little worse than mine.
Did you reach out to him?
Yeah, I did.
That's
nice.
That's cool. You guys were emailed. So when you had yours, he emailed you back.
Yeah, he totally did.
All right, cool.
No, but congratulations on Matt Wall. That's cool.
Yeah.
Now let me ask you this, Mike.
Yes.
Is Jimmy Fallon the only late night show host that you don't like?
I'll tell you the ones who I really love the most.
Tell me who you don't like.
I'm in the middle with Fallon.
No, you
just said he sucks. You're not in the middle.
I'm trying to cover my bases here.
You don't have to cover your bases.
Mike, I have a great deal of admiration for you, to tell you the truth.
Thank you, Chef.
Because so many people come in here and they have, I'm doing this project. I'm doing this documentary. I got this, whatever, you know, all these fundraiser for that. And nothing happens, right? And you come in here and you say, I'm going to do this TV show, Bo Shetty's Basement, and I'm raising money and da-da-da. And there are some people that were goofing on you. It's never going to happen.
Having a laugh at your expense, which we didn't care for.
And guess what? You walk in here today on Jim Norton and Sam Roberts, not to say I have a potential television show, to say, ladies and gentlemen, Bo Shetty's Basement is a real show.
TVRemix.com, fellas.
TVRemix.com.
Yeah.
You signed the deal.
Yeah, we got
inked.
Well,
inked.
You inked.
You have your show on the internet. Bo Schetti's Basement is a real thing. You did it. Yeah. You shot an episode.
It was fun. Frank, my friend Frank, directed it.
Frank directed it.
How many did you have? You have an announcer. You have, co-host.
One-man band, right?
And you went into your Michalog. Now, the Michalog is very interesting because you're sitting there. You look very comfortable. Sometimes you're looking at the camera that's on you. Other times you choose not to. Which I like. You look at the other camera.
It's hard to do monologues.
What's that?
It's hard to do monologues.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The hardest part of a monologue is typically not looking in the direction of the camera. I didn't realize that was such a challenge. But, you know, you work it out as you go on.
I had fun. The thing is, but you guys took the bull by the horn, too, because Sam has his own thing. You have your own thing after
took
this.
Took the bull by the horn?
Yeah.
Yes,
hey,
did.
What's a typical Michalogue joke for people who have not seen it?
Well, do you want
to... You know what?
Listen to a little bit of
that's
it?
A great idea.
So, here's the thing. Mike's show... is, you know, it's low budget on purpose.
Like Wayne's World, almost.
Right. Now, it's low budget on purpose because that's stylistically what you wanted to do, or because you don't have the cash to do anything
else? A mixture of both.
I see.
Yeah.
I see. That's smart. And I remember when you were pitching it, you said this isn't going to be the traditional late night show.
No.
This is going to be something totally different. And I like that instead you did something very different where you sit at a desk. You have an announcer and a guy on a couch. You welcome guests and musical acts, and you do a monologue.
And you're not wearing a suit.
So
I was going to watch you wear a suit, Jim. In fact, Frank, my director, my friend Kenny Burmester, one of the writers, said, you're not a suit and type kind of guy. I wanted
you
to wear
a
suit.
You have the whole crew behind this?
Yeah.
And no offense to Frank or anything, but when Rob said the director is Frank, I said, I assumed that Mike just hit record on the camera and then walked back to his desk. Yeah.
No. Frank shot this whole thing.
So you're not a suit guy. You don't relate to suits, do you?
I'd like to have suits. For some reason, I feel like...
Because you're old school.
But the thing is, I am in a way, like...
But you want to wear a suit. Wear a suit. It's your show.
Yeah, but you know who had great suits? Desi Arnaz. Wish I had his fucking suit dresser.
His hairdresser?
His like suits, like the 50s, but they were double breast. People like
so get a suit. Why don't you just go get a double breasted suit?
Go buy one.
I have a couple of suits.
And wear one.
Put it
on. Your show. What are you doing?
Maybe I'll
You're panicking.
Know.
Is it called Frank's Basement?
No.
It's Bo Schetti's Basement.
It's Bo Schetti's Basement.
But I had a seersucker suit I was gonna wear that day.
Seersucker suit?
Like from the 40s.
Yeah,
like,
no,
so
I know what
seersucker
is.
Mike, if you want to, first of all late night people wear a suit, so if you want to, and some maybe wearing a suit in the basement, like Steve Martin would wear crazy suits, and it didn't work for him. It just didn't work. And then one day, he put on the white suit, and the juxtaposition of his crazy fucking arrow through the head,
suit, right?
And a white suit.
The suit was awesome, Jim.
It worked. Sometimes the look works, and in your crazy basement with this announcer, and it looks very low budget, maybe you wearing a nice suit is what will work for that.
Jim, I was thinking of not only a suit, you know what I was thinking about? Tell me what you guys think it is.
Tell me.
A leopard smoking jacket, like the Big Bopper.
I mean, that's the opposite of what
Jim hopefully
just
you'll
said.
Have the same results flying. But
now,
how about a leopard skin smoking jacket?
A jacket, as long as it's a jacket, I'm saying. Like, you know,
I was going to get Max Headroom's haircut.
Yeah, anything like that, but maybe a nice dressy, because you're wearing a t-shirt, your fucking tattoo is showing. Maybe this is the rough, how many have you taped?
One, but we're supposed to do six.
I would wear a suit.
If you would like to watch the premiere episode of Bo Schetti's Basement,
you
can go to tvremix.com. It's right there on the front page. 22-minute show. Obviously, you were smart because you said, right now it's on tvremix.com, but let's make it the appropriate length so that should it get picked up by a network, you got room for commercials, right?
Absolutely.
Very smart.
Right, that makes sense. So it's on tvremix.com. You can watch it now, Bo Schetti's Basement. A couple of things, you know, it does take place, and I guess what is your basement? Now, the couch area that's next to your desk, that appears to be your bed, yes?
It is my bed.
And it's
so
your
he's
bed,
sitting on your bed.
Yeah, he's sitting on your bed.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, the thing is, you guys inspired me to work on this thing, too, because you know why?
Why?
You got to fucking keep cranking out stuff and doing things in this. You can't fucking sit in your ass
content.
But we should watch the beginning, Mike. I don't want to because we only have till 10, so I want to see the opening of Mike's. We should give it the proper promotion.
Thank you, Jim.
You're 100% right, Jim.
I'm babbling. I'm sorry, guys.
It's okay. You're excited.
Your announcer's with you, and it's odd because in the opening credits, you have an announcer and a co-host, but for half the show, you talk to your announcer and no co-host.
Well, he got there late that day.
I see.
Your co-host was late?
I see.
Yeah, he came from a funeral, I think.
You just use the announcer as the co-host.
He was coming from a biker funeral that day.
No, I know, you guys.
All right, there's a legit reason. It's a good thing you didn't work the production schedule around the funeral.
Yeah. You know how I knew it was a biker funeral?
How?
It was kind of a bit of a mundane story. So they spent about 6 minutes just talking to each other about the funeral on the show. It was a good segment. Good seg. I liked it.
It was real, though. That's what happened with it.
Hey, really, man, you got to keep it real. That's what I always say. Mike Boschetti keeps it real.
Thank you, guys.
Here we go. Can't hear it.
Spaceman! Woo! Yeah. Whip your host, Mike Boschetti!
You got an audience in that, right?
Yeah, that's cool.
One-man band. And also your co-host, Sal Palladonato.
Sal wasn't there yet.
No. I am your announcer.
Stuck on the West Shore Expressway.
Machete's only black friend, Todd Monacy. Yeah! Woo! Yeah, we're going to... Yeah.
It's kind of an awkward high five.
Why did he stand up? He's already right next to you.
Yeah. Why is he standing over you? But then again, the crowd knew to stop cheering.
That's good. And all at the same time.
How did you do together?
Nobody. We just... Frank put in a sound effect.
Really?
That doesn't sound like a sound effect.
No, there was...
I thought you had an audience in your house.
No. I could have fit more than four people down there.
Oh, wow. Well, don't say that. Don't. Okay. No.
Yeah. Now, I also had a question. Before we get to the Micalogue, you advertised Dave Hill, who I'm aware of, as a one-man band.
Yeah.
And he comes in. Jim, how do you... One-man bands, what do you think of when you think of one-man band?
Multiple instruments.
Yeah, that's exactly
right. Guitar. I picture them with the fucking cymbals between their knees.
Like Dick Van Dyke and Mary Poppins.
Yes, but you know what? He had to carry shit all from the city and Uber out there.
Now, let me ask you this, Mike. One-man band, do you know how many instruments Dave Hill plays?
I'm going to guess four or five.
He plays one.
Oh, okay.
He just plays guitar.
Oh, really? I thought he might have played drums. I'm not really sure. Yeah.
No. I meant on your show. I watched your show.
Oh, yeah. He might play a bunch of them. I don't really know.
No. He was on your show.
Oh, yeah.
It was
happened. Yeah. I love the show. Who turned first will be
right. No. I'm just... Because you... I just was curious. You advertise a one-man band on your show, and you just have a guy that plays guitar.
Plays the guitar.
Right, so...
Well, we need to change other instruments that day, but I mean, you know...
But in post, you could just stop saying he was a one-man... You could have said a guitar player Dave Hill is here. No?
No, I thought he was going to have more instruments that day. That's what happened, but he didn't.
And so he just did guitar. Oh, that makes sense.
I have a quick question for Mike.
Yeah, sure.
Are you mic'd up on your shirt, or are you just using the microphone on the recorder?
Frank, I think that was mic'd. I wasn't mic'd up that day.
You probably...
We just use it on a boom mic?
Yeah.
Or is it just the on-camera mic?
Boom, because we don't have a lab. I got to get some labs.
Yeah, that would help for a TV production.
Well, they want to shoot this in California.
Who's they?
Royce DeManzio and John Melendez is the one who produced.
Stuttering John?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Stuttering John wants to... Well, I mean, you know.
It's his thing, and Royce is his partner.
All right, so Stuttering John's in California. Is he still in California?
Yeah, but they have a full crew on a soundstage over there. I want to take it out there.
Are they going to fly you out?
Yeah, they want to just put together... We're working on a schedule now. They want to shoot two in a day.
You want to make... They want to make sure that they get you when you're not busy.
They maybe send a list of like 15 or 20 people right now that were on there, and I put both you guys on the list as well.
Of what? A list of what?
As a guest
in L.A.
And if we're going to shoot in that,
that would give us a reason to go out there.
To do Boschetti's Basement?
Yeah, because they want to shoot two in a day, because you know what? But you guys were in some great company. I picked some cool people.
Who else? I worry that our agent Tony Burton will get pissed if we're going behind his back and making these big arrangements without him.
Well, I'm just saying the company could send us out there.
No, but you guys are in some great company. I picked all people I love.
Who?
I picked Darnell Rawlings, who I know forever.
Darnell?
Right, you guys? Mm-hmm. I picked, what do you call it, Zach Galifianakis.
Sure.
Oh, cool. Zach's going
to
do it.
Have you talked to Zach recently?
I can get him, though. Alex Sulkin from The Family Guy is a great friend. He loved this, actually.
How do you know you can get Zach?
I'll be able to get him.
Nice.
I'm not worried about it.
You know him for a long time.
Is the production studio, are they worried about the integrity of the show when you go to L.A. to do Boschetti's Basement and you're on a soundstage?
They can make it look like this.
Sure. They can mimic this.
But wouldn't this be like when Wayne's World goes to the big studio and it becomes a nightmare?
They want to shoot some stuff on the street over there, too, because you know what is a cool place to shoot?
Where?
Little Brea Tar Pits in L.A. is awesome.
Would you jump in?
No.
Okay. Are they still hot?
I don't know.
Maybe dip your toe.
I was a little disappointed by them, though.
Yeah, they're boring, right? Bunch of tar.
Yeah, but Jim, you think it's like... pterodactyls fucking hanging out of the thing. You don't see that kind of shit there.
Not in 60 million years.
Pterodactyls are extinct.
No, but I'm saying, but it's supposed to be the tar pits. Where are the bones hanging out of the tar?
They put them in the museum.
Yeah, what do you think? Bones just stick out of the
tar? That's what I thought.
No.
Yeah, when I went
no, they, to, they wouldn't. They don't just leave dinosaur bones outside in California.
I thought, well, Sabretooth would. Well, that's how the Sabretooth died off over there.
Why do you keep putting up Sabretooth tigers?
I seen a documentary on them recently. I was watching.
That's like the second or third time this morning you brought up Sabretooth tigers,
yeah, but
man.
But they the tar pitched those guys in.
Okay. All right, let's go to the Micalog and just get a taste of Bo Shetty's Basement, which is available at tvremix.com.
Thank you, guys. I owe you guys for this. Okay,
we owe you.
No, it's a mutual thing. But once we get this going...
Scratch our back, we scratch yours.
Would you guys come out to do this or no?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. First class.
Yeah.
First class, right?
Sure.
Yeah. Obviously. Okay, let's go to...
Do you like the Hindenburg?
Hey, but we'll figure this out. Yeah!
All right. Other sorts of black and white.
You know, I'm getting tired of these other mutton fuckers. You know, obviously, like guys talk about the tri bullshit and monologues and all kinds of nonsense. I want to talk about something that's important to me. I want to do the Micalogs.
Okay, so this is what Micalogs. I like. Micalog, he's differentiating himself.
Sure.
A lot of the other hosts. Why don't you like other hosts' monologues?
It depends on who it is.
You just said you don't. A lot of these other hosts, you said contrived. You made the statement.
I'm just breaking balls with them, but I really
you're not breaking. You're saying
you're being aggressive.
Yeah,
you got to be aggressive in this. You know what I mean? Because these guys aren't really close to each other. These late night guys,
right?
Right.
Look what happened with Leno and Letterman for years.
What happened? I
mean, were they friends?
At one time, they were actually.
Oh, perfect.
No, but they wrote for Good Times years ago. As writers together years
so
ago.
So that's what this is.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. They wrote for. Okay. They did with. Wrote for Good Times.
So what separates the Micalog from the monologue?
It's basically the same thing, but, you know, my version of it. You know what I mean?
I see. So
but Sam, the thing is, like the late night wars they had years ago, Leno and Letterman, and I'll tell you the truth, I like Letterman better.
Ah.
Wow. Way to take a shot here.
All right.
Man. Well, you know why?
It's Jay, weird for a comedian to say that.
Jay is great what he did, and he had a great car collection. I love his cars.
Well, he'd be happy to hear that.
While you're out there, you guys could cross-promote.
No, but the thing about him
is... Do you want to hear a Micalog?
No, very much.
Can I just say one quick thing, guys?
By the way, this says Micalogs.
Well, it's spelled wrong, but I don't give a shit.
It's plural. Like, each joke is a Micalog?
Yeah.
No, but the thing is, but they're two different kind of people. When you think about it, right? Letterman was more... What do you call it? Leno was more of a stand-up than Letterman was, for sure.
Right. How is this helping you promote your show?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just talking about
that. Yeah, I was just wondering, like, does each joke count as a Micalog?
Yes.
I see. Okay. I see. And that's what makes it different. A monologue is just one thing.
This goes
Micalogs are many.
Many. Many. The few
that's cool. I like that.
Let's hear the first Micalog.
First Micalog.
Okay. Shaquille O'Neal just joined the board of Papa John's Pizza.
Mike, what
you got to get loves. The bottom, this is one of the biggest things that make a production sound good or not good is not just the lighting, but that weird,
lighting has nothing to do with how a production sounds.
When you sound like you're in a, like you're just putting a recorder in a room, you have to get a love for this to be professional. You have to.
Also, it appears that you're looking at the wall.
Yeah.
I was trying to look away from Cam. You know what I mean?
Why would you do that when you're talking to people at home?
Like, it's not connecting with the audience because
it's not the time to be shy.
It appears that you're telling a joke to the wall.
Well, the thing is, Jim knows, and you guys know acting wise, will tell you never look in camera.
Yeah, but you're not acting.
You're doing Micalogs.
You're talking to an audience that's not there.
Oh, that's different.
You're supposed to look towards the camera.
Looking in camera like an interview.
So, but let's say if you're acting, like, what is your character doing right now? Just telling jokes to a wall?
Yeah.
He's telling jokes to the thing. He thinks there's people there.
So wait a minute. So when you're when you're doing stand-up, like on Last Comic Standing, didn't you look into the camera?
No, I tried not to.
Okay.
Or maybe, you look at the audience.
You look at the direction of the camera. You don't look away. You didn't look to side stage.
Right. No, Jim, but it was different. Like, when they did it at the Alex Theater in L.A. when I did it the second time.
That explains it.
Sure does. Okay, let's go
to the Micalogs.
Racial stereotype universe. Larry Bird just joined and bought a Popeye's chicken. President Trump is in golf with a Kid Rock in Florida. Make sure he nails down the white trash vote. Next week, he's scheduled to play lawn darts with Will Durst.
Fred Durst.
Okay, President Trump was just seen golfing with Kid Rock in Florida. Make sure he nails down the white trash road. Next week, he's scheduled to play lawn darts with Fred Durst.
Now, Mike, were you happy that they left in both takes?
Yeah, I was.
You like that?
Yeah,
that's the preference.
Some fun.
Having some fun.
Yeah, but Will Durst is a political comic. Fred is a.
Fred is the lead singer of.
Bananarama.
Correct. Who wrote
it?
Did you?
Who's the one that fucking I killed them all?
That was Robert Durst.
Robert Durst.
So, Mike, can I ask you a question?
Sure, Sam.
Who wrote this joke?
My friend Ken Burmeister.
I see. Okay. So the Mike-a-log written by Ken Burmeister.
Oh, no, there's two people who wrote. Neil Berliner.
Okay, so those are the two people. Mike Buschetti, not one of the third?
I may have added stuff.
But you have writers, but everyone has a writing staff.
Yeah, I may have added stuff and okayed them. You know what I mean?
I see. You are the filter.
Yeah.
I see.
Can we hear one more Mike-a-log?
I think so. Maybe, I mean, we may have time for two Mike-a-logs.
All right.
Yeah.
You guys
Trump just tweeted he didn't think Saturday Night Live was funny. So what? After the first sketch, nobody else does either.
That was kind of obnoxious.
McDonald's employee with Down syndrome was recently celebrated 27 years with the company. Big deal. He flips hamburgers, tries to do a comedy for 27 years with Asperger's.
That wasn't one of my favorites. I didn't.
Do you have Asperger's?
No.
I think it would have been funnier if you didn't say with Asperger's. If you just said big deal, tried doing comedy for 27 years, then the implication is that you're saying you have Down syndrome, even though you don't. It's just that you know.
People confuse me for those people, but I'm not.
Then why did you say it?
People confuse me for those people. Like what people do you mean? Like doctors?
No, that's why Jim, I never wore baseball caps because I swear to God, I looked like I was collecting money for Jerry Lewis if I stood on the corner long enough.
Did the people collecting money for Jerry Lewis wear baseball caps?
No, I just look like them because, you know what I mean?
Hat?
I don't know. I just got a weird look. I'm not exactly fucking Brad Pitt. You know what I mean? So.
No, you're La Brea Tar.
I was thinking how long I know Jim today. Sam, how long I know Jim? You were 4 days old. That's
a long. Is that right? 35 years?
Wow.
No, not 30. Oh, wait, no. 35. not that far.
No, early 90s. 92, maybe.
Oh, okay. So that was much.
Well, 28 much. Years, right? Well, yeah. Sam was like so. 7, right? Yeah.
Yeah, we know like a long time.
I was older. I actually, can we fast forward?
Sam,
Mike
your beard looks good.
Thank you very much,
You know what? People rag about it online, but they're assholes.
Well, they just are taking Jim's cues. He starts
I'm
that.
Sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you're sorry.
It's all good-natured.
I'm sorry, guys. No, but don't I love sorry. It, Sam. Fuck him. Anybody that don't like him, they can fucking eat a dick burger.
You talking
burger.
About Jim?
Sure.
Eat a dick burger, Jim.
I would. Not the bread, though, for carbs.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but he bought
can I have my dick burger on a collard green wrap?
What do you want to fast forward to?
Yeah, I wanted to fast forward to, it's about 6 minutes and 15 seconds in, because Mike does a Man on the Street segment.
Oh, let's see that.
They do a segment where, again, the announcer... Which I do feel like is taking the place of the co-host.
He sounds like Jerry Lewis. I love Todd Montes. He's a good guy.
At some point, for some reason, Mike starts bringing up Crispus.
Oh, Crispus Attucks.
Crispus
Attucks. That's our black and white history section.
Okay. I see.
To differentiate between black and white. There's no people still the same, but we're trying to like get it out there where we are the same. Nobody's so different than anybody else.
He wants to get a Crispus Attucks Day.
Sure.
Yeah.
A national holiday.
Well, he was a hero. The guy was one of the first Americans killed by the British douchebags.
He's black, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so the bit
is... Native American, too, I think they said. Jimmy's both. Okay. Half and half, I think.
The bit is that the announcer, who is not the co-host, but hosting with you at the time, is he's going to go out on the street in Staten Island and get signatures.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go.
To make Crispus Attucks Day a national observed holiday.
Yep.
Can you help me get some signatures on the street?
We're going to go on the street to do this?
Yeah.
All right, this is definitely going to be on Amazon, right? This is definitely going to be on TV?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Could you pause for a sec? Just all to right. clarify, is this available on Amazon?
We're working on it.
So at the moment?
I don't know what's going on. We're just waiting to hear from them still.
Well, where is this available?
Oh, TVRemix.com.
Sorry. Okay. So not Amazon, though.
No.
Okay.
You figured you'd leave that
break his balls. I was going to tell him it's Netflix, HBO, you know, Comedy Central, all to get people involved, you know. But
I see. Sure. Let's scroll back just a tiny bit, Freud, just because we don't want to miss the nuance, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
I just signed a petition. I just put together a petition to make Christmas Addicts Day a national observed holiday.
Yep.
Can you help me get some signatures on the street?
We're going to go on the street to do this?
Yeah.
All right, this is definitely going to be on Amazon, right? This is definitely going to be on TV?
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
All right, I'll help you out.
Hey, Todd.
Oh, boy.
How'd you do with the signatures?
Not good, Buschetti. We're in Staten Island, and we're trying to get a black guy his own holiday. Not good!
That's the end.
Where's the... Wait. That's the end. Wait. You didn't film the man on the street stuff?
No, we didn't have time to, because... But I was, no, but you know what I was going to say? I told him I was going on the street, and I did become a follower of Farrakhan.
Wait, what do you mean you didn't have time to?
We just didn't, we just made it look like we were going to film it on the street. We didn't.
But you didn't do anything with that.
Because we would have been killed on the street over there where I live.
Didn't go anywhere.
No, you just said this for Christmas Addicts, and then you didn't film anything.
No.
No, didn't do it.
No, we talked about Addicts because I think he should be a hero because he's one of the first people killed
by
the
British gunfire. You sit there and there's this whole conversation about Christmas Addicts. Yeah. And you're going like, well, obviously this is leading somewhere. And that was it.
Yeah. I mean, but the thing is, but when you think about it, right?
It's actually pretty good.
He was actually murdered by the fucking British soldiers in 1770, Boston Massacre.
You want to see the introduction to Dave Hill, the one-man band?
Very much.
I love Dave.
Dave, we were discussing earlier, he's a one-man band.
Guitar. He said I could sing.
He plays guitar. Guitar. So he's not even going to sing either, so he'll just be a one-man band.
Dave,
the band consists of guitar.
Guys, you said I could sing.
Cool. Well, you are allowed to. It's your show.
Yeah.
No, but I would love to hear, but I really sing in real life. I love music.
It's Shetty's Basement.
I loved...
song would you sing?
Oh, A Country Boy Can Survive by Hank Williams Jr. Love that song.
How's that go?
The preacher man said it's the end of time. The Mississippi River, she's running dry. The stock market's up and the prices are down. You only get mugged if you go downtown.
That's actually pretty good.
That's it.
We say grace and we say ma'am. If you're not with that, then we don't give a damn. I lose back in the woods, you see. The dog and the woman in the kitchen.
Man, that's quite good. That is quite good.
I love that song.
Yeah, your collars are well pressed.
It's a really flattering shot.
Oh, God. You guys are not... you know what I like about you guys? You're not breaking my balls, but you're not nasty and mean guys. A lot of people...
We're proud of you. You did it. You pulled it off. Like, a lot of people talk about doing it, and they want to do it, and they're too scared, or they don't want...
You know what?
You pulled it off. You
have to have balls, and you can't be afraid of anything in this.
That's right. You wanted a one-man band. You got a guy that played guitar. You still called him a one-man band. Good for you.
I don't care. You know why? Because
lie to the audience. What difference does it make?
I want to hear this guy's introduction.
Okay. Dave Hill.
From Buschetti's Basement, the great Dave Hill.
He's great. But it's just the one instrument.
But now,
hey Mike.
Hey Dave. You think I could play guitar? Or
See, that's the important thing when you're going to do this. It's like when Carson would talk to Doc Severinsen or Tommy Newsom. It's the magic in the interaction.
Yeah, I like having a guitar player on, and then the first question is, can I play guitar?
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah, it's a good place to start. It's a good question.
Yeah.
Is that a dumbbell you got on the desk there?
Yes.
Behind it.
It's 3 pounds. Oh, you bastard. I just got that. No, but I got some cool props on the table. Guys, those little mini cones from I bought in the $5 store. That thing is so cool. That green-looking thing was awesome.
I don't know if that's the word, but yeah, let's go on with the Dave Hill segment just a little bit.
Anyone can do it.
Could you do me a huge favor? Can you play Sweet Home Alabama? Turn it up!
I gotta be honest. If I could hang out with a guitar player, all I would do is ask him to do shit like that.
Yeah.
When I was in high school, there was a guy named Lester Cosmo, and he could play guitar. And I remember him sitting there in the hallway playing Symptom of the Universe.
Uh-huh.
And I would have fucking moved in with him and been his roommate, just listen to him play guitar all day.
Well, this is where it gets magic.
I love a guy who can just play guitar.
I love music. It really is incredible. Wish that I could play. I'm a spastic.
When somebody can just play guitar, I consider them a one-man band.
I do too.
Jimi Hendrix. Oh, Dimebag Darrell was amazing. Jimi Hendrix. There's nobody like those guys.
Dave Hill.
Yeah.
Dave Hill. Sure. Hendrix. Jeff Beck.
Tony Iommi. Randy Rhoads.
Yeah.
Randy Rhoads.
Tommy Lee.
Tommy Lee. Dimebag Darrell and Hendrix are my favorites.
Yeah. Mick Mars.
It goes on and on.
Yep. Well, Vince Neil.
John Bonham.
Oh, no. John Bonham was a drummer.
Oh.
Oh.
You tried to get me, Jimmy.
I did.
I made a mistake.
You got to wake up pretty early in the morning.
Keith Moon was a drummer.
Jerry
as well.
Page.
Jimmy Page was, was a guitarist. Yeah.
Let's see this magic.
Yep.
No, but the cool thing is, when I went to turn it up, I was trying to remember if the next words were. I forgot the first part of it. It's such a great song.
Big wheels.
Oh yeah, big wheels.
I forget. Big wheels keep on turning. Is it dim?
Get me home to see my kin.
Turn it up.
You forgot the words to the song.
Yeah, you did.
Dave, I actually seen that recently. I love
Leonard Skinner.
No, I mean the original band. I mean on YouTube, right? I'm watching it.
Oh yeah.
And I
seen them. I originally saw them.
The original band, not Leonard Skinner.
Yeah, the originals.
The original.
you mean the pre-plane crash Skinner?
Oh yeah.
Do you? You know he has guests.
Yeah, I would hope so.
You know who he had on the first show?
Hey, Jack.
he had Joe Pesci on the first show.
Oh, let's hear Joe Pesci.
1511. Oh yeah,
that
I mean, Travis, do you have a request? You had a favorite part?
Well, yeah. Before we move on from Dave Hill,
I was gonna skip it.
Okay,
you can if it's your favorite part. I don't want to take it away from
Thank you.
I like the Hemp Report.
The Hemp Report?
I want to do more with the Hemp Report. I love pop.
I don't see how you could. You don't think you've run the well dry with this one? All right. We go to exactly 10 minutes in, and Micah has Dave Hill do the Hemp Report.
Dave, I have a special segment with Dave.
Did his guitar playing interrupt you?
When we do the Hemp Report, right?
I like music, so I didn't really care.
Yeah.
I see.
Special segment with Dave Hill with the Hemp Report.
Mm-hmm.
And just look like you're like, wait, like stone, like, can I go Dave? Dave.
Yeah.
It's a good way to work this segment out in show.
In intro.
Did you know that was going to be on the air? Where you work out what the segment is beforehand?
No.
Now, you didn't think to yourself before.
I had a segment I was going to do with Todd called Off Color Carpet.
Right. You didn't think before Dave sat down, maybe you'd run by what you're doing? You figured once you sat down at the desk.
I figured improv on TV, you know what I mean? Have some fun.
You figured that they would cut that out.
Yeah.
Cut that part out. Yeah.
You see, they're going to go right to it, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a very special segment with Dave Hill right now called The Hemp Report. This is for you hemp heads and party people out there. The Hemp Report with Dave Hill. Dave?
Dave's just looking around.
Dave! Dave! Well, that's the Hemp Report, Dave Hill.
He said he's laughing good-naturedly. Okay, that's it. I mean, that's it.
Dave
Hill
is really
looking,
good.
Troy, it seemed like you were looking for the out.
Yeah, I didn't know what was going on.
You didn't know where the Hemp Report ended.
Well, because he said the Hemp Report, and then he just starts shredding.
He's very good.
What do you see him? You see him looking around though.
Yeah.
That was the.
Yeah, but you could be high during a shemp. You could be high playing guitar during a Hemp Report too.
That's
right.
Cool.
Right.
Okay. So you want
to
hear?
We have to hear Joe Pesci. Yeah. As we're running out of time, and we have to. I have to be the big celebrity.
Yeah.
There we go.
As a loop. Oops. We got to go forward to 1511.
That's what I want on this show. Just Dave Hill to break in the songs.
I mean, that'd be cool.
I would enjoy that. All right, here, 15.
I'm very, very excited to have our next guest tonight. He's a legend in the world of acting. I've been a huge fan of his forever. And I know talk show hosts shouldn't be groveling about people like this, but he's well worth the grovel. Come on in, Mr. Joe Pesci.
Hey, I heard you groveling in the back room for me back there. Stop groveling. Thought you didn't have to grovel like I'm a puppy dog. Okay, you're lucky I'm here.
So, Joe, what's been going on since Goodfellas?
Okay, Mike, I do have a question to ask you. Why did you decide the Joe Pesci interview is the time that you would look into the camera?
Yeah, when you're not looking at your guests.
If you had looked at the wall where you did your Micalogs, it would have looked like you were looking at yourself as Joe Pesci. But instead, you decided into the camera with the questions.
I don't really... I have no answer to that question.
It wasn't an artistic
choice. You were alive in the moment.
Yes.
I see.
Why don't you try like a different outfit? He's wearing the exact same outfit.
Yeah. I didn't realize.
He took his glasses off.
He just took it, but like, why wouldn't you put on something else?
A different shirt.
Yeah.
I didn't really realize. At the time, I was just, we're going on with it. I didn't really like.
He didn't realize. Off the cuff. Understandable. Yeah.
I try my best.
You want to hear a little more?
Yeah, but a lot, sure.
I've done since Goodfellas. When was the last time you get out of your cave? Oh, I forgot. This is Corporal Shetty's basement, pally. I wouldn't be too critical if I were you, pal. Yeah, Goodfellas. You weren't even... Oh, you were born, but you were still...
Oh, you were...
Half an embryo at the time, pally. What do you mean I never did one in an infomercial and you never heard of me before? What are you doing here? What are you doing here? It's
Mike.
A paycheck, buddy. What do you think it is?
Mike... He didn't say anything about an infomercial. The question, when you said, what do you mean, and then you said something, Joe didn't say that.
I don't really, I'm not.
Joe didn't, when you said, what do you mean, Joe didn't say the thing that what you said after, what do you mean.
I'm not a technician, really.
Yeah, that's fair. It's not your responsibility.
No?
No, I'm not really
Mike's
sure.
Mike's just the talent.
Were you confused by that?
Yep.
Life is confusing.
Oh, that's true.
Well, where can we see this?
OutTVRemix.com, guys.
You don't want to hear a little more Joe Pesci?
You know who else I got there? Hey, it's Jack.
Well, let's see that. I have to go shoot something. So let's
okay.
Let's see that.
Go to 17.
I would like to see the... I want to see Jack.
I love Jack.
Here we go.
By his work, the great Jack Nicholson. Hey, man. It's Jack. I just want to say I think you're magnificent what you do because I've been stalking, I mean not stalking, but I've been watching you on the net and I see what I like.
I heard that you came here off a movie set to see me tonight and be on the show. I am completely flattered. You were well worth coming down for.
Mr. Nicholson, the timing is really, really, really strong.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It seems like you guys are just sitting there on the couch shooting the shit like the old days.
Very conversational. Do you want to end with the clip at 1940?
Sure.
Oh, thank you, guys.
Okay, yeah. We'll end with the clip at 1940.
And you could go support Mike's show, and he'll do some more of these.
Yeah, if you go to TVRemix.com, you can watch the first episode in full of Bo Shetty's Basement. We just wanted to give you a little taste.
Thank you, guys.
If they're going to speak English, you don't know if they're going to have your sense of humor. And I had to do it anyway, but it was mostly like British tourists and college students, and they were great. They were awesome.
Guys, can we take a break? Because I'm going to eat this if I don't have food serving.
Can I watch you eat that? I say keep filming.
I can see that Richey just eats that type of stuff. That would be great. Like Richey just eats this.
What, though? I'm usually used to crayons. You know?
They're not filming you. They're just showing your co-host chewing gum.
And also just wondering, why did they leave in the show when you said, hey, for you to just stop the taping midway through and say, can I have something to eat?
I'm starving. I had like two pizzas when I got that. They were so good.
Two now, pizzas?
You know how I know you ate both pizzas? Because I watched the credits.
Oh, really?
Did you see the credits? Though.
Guys, I want to bring it up here next time. If I can.
I wish you brought it up this time.
They're not open as early.
Ah, well, next time we'll be on later.
No, no. You guys like cheese? This pizza's like from the hills of Sicily. I love it.
Now, were you happy? Did you watch the show back?
Yes.
Are you happy with it?
I had a great time doing it. I love it.
But were you happy with how it looked?
Yeah, because we got some great feedback from you guys. Alex Sokin liked it. Some great people
I would
it.
Say get a love. That's my only criticism.
I thought it was a great show.
We had a good time with this.
Yeah.
Thank you for having us in today.
You're very welcome,
course,
Mike.
Of course. And there's an Easter egg. If you watch the whole show, there was a moment that I noticed where you can actually hear, I think it's Mike Buscetti's mom.
Oh, yeah.
Upstairs. And she's just, you know, going about her business. But it's not referenced at all. Like, I thought it was a bit, like the King of Comedy. Mom, I'm busy. But they don't even reference it.
No, so if you pay attention, you'll hear it.
It's an Easter egg.
She was going to come downstairs, but she I don't want to bother her.
Well, I hope that the other late night shows are shaking in their boots.
Well, I'll put it this way. Carson is going to be working for me one day. I love Daly.
Oh, they miss Johnny.
Carson Daly's awesome.
He's not on late night anymore.
No, but he will be again someday.
He does mornings now.
No, yeah. But I think he's one of the best.
We got to end the show. It's 10 o'clock.
Okay, sorry, guys.
No, don't be sorry.
We July 5th, Jim will be at the Borgata.
Yep. And check and support Mike's show so we can do some more.
TVRemix.com is where you can go watch Bo Shetty's Basement. You got it done.
All right.